Hey guys, welcome back to another episode. So, you know, we've talked about the rule of 72 and like a couple other investing things to look for retirement. But today, we'll talk about a little different one called the rule of 25. This is actually seen a lot in like the FIRE movement, right? Financial independence, retire early. Because, you know, whether retirement's going to be, you know, right around the corner or a couple decades away, like you really want to be prepared, right? Because being prepared is like it's the main goal, right? That's the key. And you know, it's never too early or too late to contribute towards, you know, a comfortable retirement, right? So the multiply by 25 or the 25x rule of thumb is just going to be a simple way to estimate the amount of retirement savings you're going to need to build based on the income you'd like to live off of when you are retired. So what we're going to do is we're going to dig a little bit deeper into the rule. We're going to find out why it works and how you can use it to calculate your ideal retirement savings amount, right? So first off, the multiply by 25 rule is relatively straightforward to apply. So first, figure out what annual salary you'd like to have during retirement. So, you know, let's say, you know, just pick a number. You want to live off $40,000, $60,000, $100,000, right? And then, you know, you're going to multiply that amount by 25 to determine the total amount you need to save up for retirement. So let's take an example. Let's say I want to live off of, say, $60,000 U.S. per year in retirement, right? So you'd multiply that by 25, and then that would mean you'd get 1.5 million saved by the time you retire. Like, that's what you need, right, to live off 60,000 per year, right? Because, you know, once you calculate your ideal retirement savings amount, you know, that's when you can start working towards building, you know, your retirement savings and your investments to reach that goal. And you might be like, oh, 1.5 million, that's so much. But if you want to live off 60,000 per year, I mean, that's the goal you need to go by. So let's talk about why the, you know, rule of 25 or the 25X retirement rule of thumb, like, why does it generally work, right? Well, the multiply by 25 rule provides a lump sum retirement amount that allows you to make regular annual withdrawals for 30 years, right? Which is, it's a time frame based on a study by a financial advisor. And he, you know, he posited that withdrawing 4% of your retirement reserves and adjusting for inflation each year was 100% successful in funding a 30-year retirement. So the, you know, the rule of 25 or the 25X rule of thumb, it works because it allows you to make a comfortable estimate of your retirement needs without factoring in different variables. So, you know, like I said earlier, like if you're going to live off 60,000, right, and you need 1.5 million, that's a lot, but you don't necessarily have to save every dollar of your 25X amount yourself, right? Your employer match contributions to your 401k and compound interest on your investments will also count towards your 25X goal. So, of course, like anything else, this is going to come with a grain of salt, right? So this rule of thumb is going to be based on an estimate of the amount that you can withdraw from your portfolio. Therefore, it's somewhat, how about we say, limited, right? Because it does not factor in other sources of retirement income. So pensions, rental properties, Social Security, you know, any other business or anything like that, any other type of income, right? I think the estimate is something like you yourself need to generate something like 40 to 45% of your retirement income from savings, right? But also, this rule of thumb also assumes your savings right, will produce enough of a return that your annual 4% withdrawals will not deplete your principal before you die. So to counter market risk, some experts suggest retirees keep most of their portfolio in safer investments like bonds, CDs, and cash, which tend to have lower returns. This means a 25x retirement savings goal may not be enough. Personally, what I would say is I don't think I would follow that. I know that there's other rules that people, you know, using your age as a percentage, you know, if you're, you know, like if you're 30, you should be 30% into bonds, 70% into stocks. If you're 60, you know, you're 60% into bonds, 40% into stocks, so on and so forth. You know, I don't know. I think it comes down to personal preference and the amount of money you actually have saved. I don't think anyone could tell you how much risk you should be taking or shouldn't be taking. I think that comes down to individual preference. And I would say that, you know, you should save, you know, like the 25X is good, but you should save as much, like have that as a starting point, right? But since the 25X rule is based on a 30-year withdrawal period, you may need to save more as well, right? Because particularly if you plan to retire early, right? One out of every six, or what is it? One out of every, it's either six or seven 65-year-olds lives to about 95, right? So if you retire at, say, 65, live to 95, well, that's your 30 years. But, you know, I personally know people who are over, you know, 100. Or maybe you're going to retire, maybe you retire at 45, right? Well, that gives you 50 years, right? And you need much more than 25X. So, you know, it only applies for if you plan on retiring around the age of, like, when you were, well, I won't say what age to retire, but as long as you plan on being retired for 30 years, right, that 25X rule would really suit you well for that 30-year period, right? But then it comes down to the 25X rule versus the 4% rule. The 25X rule comes from the 4% rule of thumb, right, which says you can withdraw 4% of your retirement savings each year, and that it will last 30 years. To get to the original value of a retirement that lets you withdraw 4% each year, multiply the annual withdrawal by 25. So if you follow the multiply by 25 rule to save for retirement, following the 4% rule should allow you to live on your retirement savings for 30 years. Right? So they kind of go hand in hand. It's like they're reverse of each other, basically, okay? And it just comes down to, honestly, whichever you prefer. I would say you can follow the 25 rule, the 4% rule. They're basically the same thing. I hope this guys like helps you guys get a little bit closer to your goals or understanding what your goals might be. If you like the video, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe if you're not subscribed. And that's all. I'll see you guys in the next video. Y'all be safe.